लेट मी कन्वे, वेदर स्क्रीन इज विजिबल, वेदर स्क्रीन इज विजिबल,
यस सर। सो
हाँ वेरी गुड, विल स्टार्ट द लेक्चर। सो गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी, एज पर द सिलेबस एंड यू विल बी फेसिंग द एनसेम एग्जाम एंड दोज एनसेम एग्जाम शैल बी बेस्ड ऑन यूनिट नंबर 3, यूनिट नंबर 4, यूनिट नंबर 5 and unit number 6, and it has the weightage of 50 marks, and all the questions are set on MCQs. So better to we'll study the chapter first, then we'll go for the MCQs. That way you have to learn the subject. And today you have selected the chapter dimensional analysis, similitude, and the model analysis is one of the chapter under the unit 3. And second chapter is related to the boundary layer theory, so that will be assigned for the unit 3. Unit 4 is represents as the laminar flow and the turbulent flow as well as flow through the pipe, and unit 5 it is only for the flow through the open channel as well as the depth energy relationship and the uniform flow, and the last unit is totally depends upon the gradually varied flow and the flow around the circular body. So we'll start this unit, dimensional analysis, similitudes, and the model analysis. So as per the title, what is the background behind this? Although many practical engineering problems, or the hydraulic problems, those problems may be related to the design aspects, those problems may be related to the complexities, you can be able to solve it now here by utilizing the equations as well as the analytical procedures. So that way you have to be solve the complexities. So those complexities is going to be observed on field. So yet a large number of the problems rely on the experimental data, so you will be getting the solutions. So the by performing the experiment you will be getting the solutions, by utilizing the analytical equations you will be getting the solutions, but how to analyze those equations, how to represent those equations, that is a matter. So you have to arrange the equation on a such way that so that you will be able to solve the problems related to the fluids, related to the field. So in general, solution is also obtained through a use of the combination of the analysis is one part, and the experimental data you have to be collected it as per the results obtained through the laboratory setups. And obvious that is goal of any experiment is to make the results as widely applicable as the possible. So for achieving the goal, so better option you have to go with the concept of the similitude. Why you need to learn this dimensional analysis chapter? Why have to go for the model analysis? Because of that immediately we'll be getting the solutions, and that measurements made on the one system, that is on laboratory scale, can be used to describe the behavior of the other system, so which is lying outside the laboratories. That means it is on field now. Now the laboratory systems are usually thought of as a model, that is the preparation of the model. So the model, it has the scales. As per the scale, you prepare the model. Then use up to study the phenomena of the interest under the carefully controlled conditions. In model study, you have to utilize the formulas, equations called the empirical formulations can be developed with that, and the specific productions of one or more characteristics of some other similarity system can be made. However, to do this, it is necessary to establish the relationship, between the laboratory model and the other system. So right now in present topic, we will learn how to achieve this in a systematic manner, in a simplest manner. Now, as per the background, you see that is a sudden contraction in a pipe, we have seen one example. Then another thing is that if the in case of the wind turbine, how the electricity or the power is going to be generated by rotating the turbine, and that depends upon the blowing of the wind. And the problem is occurred on a foil field, like the storage of the reservoir or the overflow of the water through the spillway section. Is the exit is the overflow section of the dam, we call as the spillway number. And in case of the sudden contraction in the pipe, so when this contraction in the pipe is also takes place because of the certain problem will be occurred into the entire flow system, therefore again the flow of the behavior of the flow is going to be changed. So the dimensional analysis to product the physical parameters that will be significantly influence the phenomena under the study. And the second step in this flow diagram will go for the similitudes and the model analysis, so that to investigate the complexities of the phenomena in more details. And the next part is there where you have to apply the knowledge on actual practice or on the prototype model. Now let us discuss about this. Let us reach towards the topic, that is the dimensional analysis. So what we will define the dimensional analysis? Dimensional analysis is nothing but it's a mathematical technique making the use of the study of the dimensions. It deals with the dimensions of the physical quantity which involved in the phenomena. So it means to that in dimensional analysis, one first product the physical parameters that will be influenced. So what way it will be influencing? That is the influence of the flow. Then by grouping those parameters in a dimensional dimensionless combinations, and a better understanding of the flow phenomena is made to be possible. So it is particularly helpful in the experimental work because it provides guide to those things that significantly influence the phenomena. Also, it indicates the direction in which the experimental work should go. Mathematical technique is used in a research work for design and for conducting the model test. So the mathematics subject of mathematics is very important in fluid mechanics, is the prerequisite subject for the fluid mechanics. Now let us see that is the what type of the dimensions you learn it. So the first part is the fundamental dimension called as the primary quantities, and those quantities are to be derived based on these fundamental dimensions are to be called as a secondary dimensions or called as a derived quantities. So let us remember these two dimensions. First is the fundamental dimension and second one is the secondary dimensions or called as derived quantity. This is independent, this is dependent dimensions. So the fundamental dimensions or the fundamental quantity, so it has the LMT form, which is now in the MLT form. Please remember MLT. So what is M? M represents the mass, L represents the length, T represents as the temperature. In some of the cases, you have to be considered as the time, but now the basic dimension is the M stands for the mass, L stands for the length, and T stands for the time actually. And in some of the cases, you have to be considered as a temperature, which is now in degree centigrade. Now, always you apply the Newton's second law of the motion in fluid mechanics. So as you know, as you are aware with the Newton's second law of the motion, where it represents as the force is equal to mass into the acceleration. So mathematically, it is explained as F is equal to M into the A. Now the fundamental, as per the fundamental dimensions of this force, so the force can be represented as with these dimensions ML by T raised to 2. So it means to that ML T raised to minus 2. So that way you have to explain it. Now the types of the dimensions, already we had discussed about the fundamental dimensions. In fundamental dimensions, as you know, the time parameter is T, distance, that is a L, mass parameter is M, and you have to develop the equation, fundamental dimensions for the force, and that is now MLT raised to minus 2. Now, let us see the dimensions about the secondary dimensions are called the derived quantities. So what do you mean by the Dirac quantities? Dirac quantities are nothing but are those quantities which possesses more than one fundamental dimension. Example, what type of the examples? Velocity, you know, the velocity is defined as the distance per unit time, or the your dimensions or unit for the velocity is meter per second. How it is defined in terms of the dimension? So that is now explained in terms of this L by T. Similarly, acceleration represents as the meter per second square. In MLT form, it is explained as m raised to 0, L raised to 1 by the T raised to minus 2. Or vice versa, it can be explained as L by T square. So, but you always write the dimensions in terms of the MLT form. If the mass is not there, then you have to put up the 0, m raised to the 0. Since the velocity, density, accelerations involves more than one fundamental quantities, so it is called as the Dirac quantity. Why it is called the Dirac quantity? Because of that which involves the more than the one fundamental quantities. So see the dimensions as per the geometry, kinematic and the dynamic parameters for this flow you concern as per these characteristics, entire units and the dimensions it has given in terms of the table, that is unit, length, area, volume represents the geometry, that is fluid geometry. Then flow kinematics parameter, which represents as the time, velocity, acceleration and the discharge. Dynamic characteristics for this fluid are represents as this mass, force, pressure, energy and the power. So unit it has given here, and the dimensions in MLT form, you didn't consider this, it is in the FLT form. You need to be considered in MLT form for L, then for discharge is L raised to 3 by the T. But in routine practice, you write M raised to 0, L raised to 3 and the T raised to minus 1. That way you write the dimension. That way you write the dimension. So please correct it. And the mass, force, pressure, energy also M. For force, MLT raised to minus 2. For pressure, ML raised to minus 1, T raised to minus 2. For energy and for the power. Now, methodology of the dimensional analysis. What are the methodologies? What are the methods you have to be applied in the dimensional analysis? So, the basic principle is the dimensional homogeneity. As per the, according to the Fourier's principles, you have to make the statements for the dimensional homogeneity when the equation is dimensional homogeneous. So which means that the dimensions of each term in an equation on both sides must be equal. So we are comparing the dimensions on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side. So the such an equation in which the dimensions of each term on both sides are remain the same, then you called as this equation is the dimensionally homogeneous equations. And such equations are independent of a system of the units. Example under that, suppose you are considering the equation for the velocity, equation of the velocity v is equal to root of the 2gh. V is equal to root of 2gh or 2gh raised to 1 half. So the left hand side dimension is L by T, that is now LT raised to minus 1, and the dimensions on the right hand side, let us see, that is root of the 2gh, so which indicates the LT raised to minus 1. So both the dimensions on left hand side and the right hand side, that is the dimensions of LHS and the RHS are equal, henceforth this equation you called as a dimensionally homogeneous equation. Then methods of the dimensional analysis. If the number of variables involved in a physical phenomena are known, then the relation among the variables can be determined by using the two methods. That is by using the Rayleigh's method, and second one is by using the Buckingham and Pi theorem method. So let us derive this dimension. Why this chapter is very important now here. So if you have the problem on hydraulic structure, then definitely by preparing those models, while preparing the models, all these fundamental dimensions must be needed, and you have to develop the non-dimensional parameter, or you try to develop the dimensionless parameter, and according to those dimensions where we are considering, that is geometric similarities, as well as where we are considering the kinematic similarities, as well as we are considering the dynamic similarities, according to that you have to develop the model by selecting a proper scale and the problems on the field. Immediately it can be solved, you have to do the exercise on the developed model so that you will be getting the solutions, and as per the solutions, as you know the scale, you have to apply on the field, and so that the changes on the field immediately it can be possible according to the, your solutions with the model. So that's why the model analysis chapter is very much important in fluid mechanics. So therefore, you know, CWPRS, which is now available, it's a research center, it's a central government body which is available near to the Pune, and that is now located at the Khadakwasla. Also the MERI is another unit where the models are to be developed by the MERI is now located at the Nashik place. So both the centers are available in Maharashtra, and they have to realize those of solutions, and definitely they have to develop, they have to modify the methods, modify the design aspects, modify the actual structures according to the solutions, and finally you will be getting the proper structures where you didn't causing the problems now. So in relay method, just I have to explain, as per the method, now Buckingham Pi theorem method, which is very much important in case of your the syllabus, it is not mentioned, only the title is given, but as a part definitely we have to explain about the relay method. So it is used for determining the expression for a variable, that is variable is the dependent variable which depends upon the maximum 3 to 4 variables. So those 3 to 4 variables are the independent quantities. But if the x is depends, or x is a function of x1, x2, x3, then what will happen? X becomes the dependent variable, while the x1, x2 and the x3 becomes the independent variable. Then let us simplify this equation. You can be develop this equation in terms of x is equal to k into k is a constant term. So this equation can be modified, simplified as per this. X is equal to k into x1 raised to a, x2 raised to b and x3 raised to c now here. So where k is a non-dimensional constant, or called as the dimensionless constant. So the a, b, c are the arbitrary powers which are obtained by comparing the powers of the fundamental dimensions. Now let us see the one example. I read the example. The resisting force R of a supersonic plane during the flight. There are the three categories of the plane, aeroplane. You know, that is the supersonic, subsonic and the hypersonic plane. According to the Mach number, you have to classify those plane. During the flight, can be considered as dependent upon the length of the aircraft as a L. Velocity is V, air viscosity, that is a mu stands for the coefficient of dynamic viscosity, air density, that is the density of air as a rho, and bulk modulus of the air as a k. So express the functional relationship between the variables and the resisting force. So according to this equation, R is depends is a function of L, V, mu, rho and the k. Then simplify this equation. So you know the R and the constant, that is this is the function. You take the constant of the proportionality as a k parameter. Here we are taken the a parameter, that is a into L raised to a, V raised to b, mu raised to c, rho raised to d and k raised to e now here, according to this method. So let us understand this method. So substituting the powers on both sides of this equation, on the left hand side, this is the R is the force, that is the resisting force. So the dimensions for the force on the left hand side is the mLt raised to minus 2, then this is the constant, is a dimension less parameter, L raised to A, L T raised to minus 1 to the power B. Then for velocity, M L raised to minus 1 T raised to minus 1 into the C. Then for the mu, M L raised to minus 3 to the power D. Rho, that is for dou, rho. And for K, which is now M L raised to minus 1 T raised to minus 2 E raised to the E. Then equating the powers of M L T on both sides. So power for the M on left hand side is only 1, M raised to 1. So add up the results for the M. So here M raised to C, I write the C. Here M raised to D, I write the D. And here the M raised to E, I write the E. So this is the way you have to go for the L. And L represents 1 on left hand side, which is now equal to A plus B plus minus C minus 3D minus E. And for the T, which is now represented as a minus 2, that is the T represents the minus 2 on the left hand side, and which is now equal to the T raised to minus 1 into the B, that means the minus B, T raised to minus 1 into the C, that means the minus C, and here the T raised to minus 2 into the E, therefore I write the minus 2 times of the E. I think you understand this, and let us go for the next step. Since the unknown values are more than the number of equations 3, so expressing A, B, C in terms of the D and the E. This is very important step. So I can write D is equal to 1 minus C minus E, then B is equal to 2 minus C minus twice E, and A is equal to, suppose you need to be explained A, so the A is equal to 1 minus B plus C plus 3D plus the E. So 1 minus of the B is the minus 2 minus C minus 2E. Here you have to derive, that is the equations in terms of the D and the E now here. So let us expressing A, B and the C parameter in terms of this D and the E now here. So the C parameters plus 3 into the 1 minus C minus E, that is a 3 times of the D plus of the E now. So simplify this equation, 1 minus 2 plus C plus 2E plus C plus 3 minus 3C minus 3E plus E is equal to 2 minus C. Therefore, substituting all these values in equation number 1. So equation number 1 is here, that is R is equal to A into L raised to A, then V raised to B, then mu raised to C, then rho raised to D. So according to this equation, you write all the exponents values. A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to, substituting all the values here, and let us simplify this. R is equal to A L square V square rho. Then write down this mu C parameter. You have to check it. C parameter mu raised to C. Then rho parameter is minus C. You take in the denominator. Then C parameter, you can be check it. So the V by the L, that is the C parameter. And that way you need to be explained, and which is now equal to C now here. Then K by rho V square is the parameter which represents as this E value. Then check all the values and write in this form. And we'll getting the equation R is equal to A rho L square V square phi. That is phi is another function, that is a function of these two parameter, mu by rho vi, k by rho v square. This is one way, that is a solution, or you can get those equations. This is another example, but I am not dictating this example because of the time constraint, and we'll go for the Buckingham Pi theorem method. So in this Buckingham Pi theorem method, next method, Buckingham Pi theorem method, the relays method becomes the laborious if variables are more than the fundamental dimensions. So the difficulty is overcome by the Buckingham Pi theorem method, which states that if there are the n number of the variables, maybe the independent or dependent in a physical phenomena, and this method is actually in practice applied for getting the solutions. So the Buckingham Pi theorem method is very much important for getting the solutions on fields. So this variable contains m fundamental dimensions. Then the variables are arranged into the n minus m dimensionless terms, which is called as a pi term. Let x1, x2, x3, x4, xn are the variables in all the physical phenomena. Xn be the dependent variable, x3, x2, x3 up to the xn are the independent variable. So let us write this equation. X1 is equal to f of x2, x2, x4 up to xn can be rewritten as, you take on the left hand side, so the f of x1, x2, x3, xn is equal to 0. So the equation is dimensionally homogeneous, that is the conditions. Equation must be dimensional homogeneous if it contains the n variables and if there are the m fundamental dimensions. Then you can be arrange the pi terms by utilizing the, or it is now equal to number of pi terms is equal to n minus m parameters, n minus m pi term. Suppose n number of variables are 6, fundamental dimensions are 3. So the 6 minus 3, it becomes the 3 terms, that is, it means to that pi terms, that is the pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 like that. Henceforth, f is the pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, pi to the n minus 1, m is equal to the 0. So the properties of the pi term, so that is very important. Pi term is the dimensionless. It is now independent of the system of the units. Division or the multiplication by a constant does not change the character. Each pi term consists of this m plus 1 variables. M is the number of fundamental dimensions called the repeating variables. Understand this. Let n, in this above case, x2, x3 parameters are the repeating variables, and those fundamental dimensions are considered here as m is equal to 3. And henceforth, pi term can be written as pi 1 is equal to x2 raised to a1, x3 raised to b1, x4 raised to the c1, and into the x1. Similarly, the pi 2 term can be explained as x2 raised to a2, x3 raised to b2, then x4 raised to c2 into the x5. So that way you explain. Also, write the equation pi terms. There are the total number of the pi terms. How many pi terms are required? That is n minus m terms are required. So according to that, you have to simplify those equations. And let us do it. And go for the next step. So the pi into n minus m is equal to x2 raised to a to the term n minus 1 m into the x3 raised to b into n minus m for x4 is equal to a into n minus m term. Because of that, you are arranging the n minus m terms. Therefore, each equation is solved by the principle of the dimensionless homogeneities, and the values of the a1, b1 and c1 etc. are obtained. Therefore, the results must be the pi 1 is equal to pi is the non-dimensional parameter, pi 2, pi 3 up to the n minus m term. Similarly, pi 2 you can be defined like this. Then methods of the selecting the repeating variables, that is very much important. Number of repeating variables are equal to the number of the fundamental dimensions of the problem. Choice of the repeating variables is governed by the following considerations. We don't forget this step. It is very important step. While selecting the repeating variables, those variables contains in the first step, it has the geometrically properties. Second, it has the flow properties. And third one, it has the fluid properties. While selecting the repeating variables, what things are to be considered? So the first thing is that while selecting the repeating variables, it must have the geometric property. Second, it must have the flow property. And third one, it must have the fluid property. So the repeating variables selected should form a dimensionless group. The repeating variables together must contain all the three fundamental dimensions, that is MLT. No two repeating variables should have the same dimension. Therefore, choice of the repeating variables, let us note it. So that is a dv rho, either it may be the dv rho or lv rho or the dv mu Navier. Please remember, the repeating variables must have the geometric property, that means the length, distance, like this. Flow property, that means the velocity, or the that is velocity is the most parameter that is connected with the kinematics, and the fluid properties, according to the fluid property, the density is the property as well as the mu property. So this is the way to select the repeating variables. Now let us see the bucking and pi theorem method. Just I will check it.